Hey guys, hi! Hey everyone, how are y'all doing? It's your girl Twin D and welcome back to my channel. If it's your first time here, welcome, welcome, welcome to the camp and thank you so much for being here. Do not forget to subscribe and after you subscribe, hit that notification bell. And guys, always make sure that you have notifications turned on your YouTube app on your cell phone, okay? Because even if you hit that bell, if you don't have it turned on your cell phone, the notification won't come in. Alright guys, anyways, before I begin, I want to announce the names of the three persons that I chose last night. Confirmation already. And it's because it's 10:01. Anyways guys, the names that I chose last night from the prayer message that will receive a free package, a free self-care package from me. You have Sugar Sweet, Suzuki, and Brenda Ayala. So I say the names again: Sugar Sweet, Suzuki, and Brenda Ayala. Guys, please email me. My email is twindflamed@gmail.com or you can check the description box. Email me please so I can get your shipping information. Thank you guys, and I think I'll continue to do this, but like with different things, you know, free reading, something like that. I'll do that. I like this, so I'll do it. And you don't have to do anything, just show up at the messages. Anyways guys, let's jump right into your message. This is No Communication Thursday. So let's jump right in. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever and ever. Amen. All right, guys, two on the dot. Let's go and let's find out what's going on with these divine masculines, no communication, and I'll be doing them all the way from Aries onto Pisces. We're doing it in 3 months. So let's see what's going on for you, Aries. Oh, guys, I'll also post the names of those whom I chose on my community. And guys, you have 2 days to respond, okay? You have 2 days to respond. But remember, your girl's going away next week. If you don't respond in 2 days, today's Thursday, you have until Saturday to respond. Okay, let's see what's going on for you, Aries, and it's 333. Okay, Father God, will Aries get communication in their first, second, or third months? Let's see what's going on for Aries. You have the Page of Wands, first month. So there won't be any communication for you guys in your first month here. Your divine masculines right now, they are focused on, how do I put this? Your divine masculine is still in this energy of entrapment. They're still feeling stuck. They are not inspired to move. They are still, see? They're still going through some struggles that they are fighting. So in your first month, Aries, there won't be any communication. Let's see what's going on for the second month here, please, for Aries. The Fool. Okay, so this is them now regaining their freedom. This is them now feeling like they can move, like they're ready to take some steps. Your person in your second month will be going through healing. To heal themselves from all of that energy there that they're stuck with, feeling trapped. So there's a possibility for a communication because they're going to be in this energy like feeling happy, feeling free. So they may reach out. So it's a possibility. Month number two. What month are we in? We're talking July, August, and September here. Oh, Aries, 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 Aries. Two of Cups in the reverse. So I think for you guys here, you are still in that, you're still at that phase of in and out energy. So even though your person will be going through some sort of healing in your second month, the third month, it's like the connection is going to be broken again because this person still has inner work to do. They still need to heal so they can move away 545 to calmer waters before they can move away to you. So Aries, your person still has some work to do here. Taurus, I see what's going on for Taurus. Will Taurus have communication in their first month? The Hangman. Okay, so they're indecisive. They're indecisive. It's like they're left in limbo. They're not sure if they're going to communicate. It's like they're sitting there. Should I not? They're not sure. Your person is single, though. Your person is single and they're working on being grounded. That's why they're in this limbo kind of energy. Releasing things. So for your first month, your person will be more busy releasing and cutting things out of their life. What about Taurus second month, please? Will they receive communication? Five of Swords. Yes, communication will be coming in for you in your second month. This person is planning that return and it's in regards to your communication. So Taurus, there will be communication for you. There will be. Your person as well is moving away to calmer waters. So it's like they are overcoming the indecision. Slowly but surely, but they're coming forward. What about the third month for Taurus, please? Yep. So the communication will be coming in, guys. It may be a struggle. It may not be what you want, but there will be communication for you, Taurus, within your second and third month. And if you're not getting the amount of communication that you wanted, it's okay because communication is building up and this person has you on their mind a lot, which is leading them towards making that final decision. Okay, Geminis, let's see what's going on for you, Geminis. Will there be communication for Geminis first month? Oh, definitely. That's like a definite yes. This is what I call heaven yes. See, your person was defending their heart here. Your person was protecting, was being defensive, like cutting people out, like just blocking off people here. Like, no, ain't nobody getting in. But look at this big old Ace of Pentacles. Now they're grounded. They're firm. This person knows exactly what it is that they want. So there will definitely be communication for you guys in the first month. Definitely. See, they know what they want. They're going to create that path to come towards you. How about the second month for Geminis, please? Will there be communication? Damn right, there will be. Yes, Geminis. Communication coming in for you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. So there will definitely be communication. Your person is looking for the perfect time to mention something, to say something here. What about the third month for Geminis, please? See that? 911, Geminis. They're waiting for the perfect moment to say something, to express their emotions, to let their heart spill out. Ooh, to offer you that love. Your person is grounded, free, single, disengaged, and ready to love. Cancer. Let's see what's going on for you, Cancers. Will your person contact you in your first month, July? Will there be communication for Cancer? Oh la la! Man, I'm loving this. Your person recently ended something here. Your person recently ended a connection that they were in. they're closing a cycle out. And your person is definitely going to communicate with you in regards to that. So it's like you're getting a little bit of freedom right here. And that communication is coming in because they're feeling that stability, that drive to, it's a push to go for what they want. What about the second month for Cancer, please? Maybe not too much. Your person wants to give back to you. This isn't much about communication. This is about their stability. So they'll communicate to you because they're going to be free from a situation that they were in. And then it's like, again, be fall back because now they want to prepare to give back to you. So your second month, there won't be much communication. See, there will be a little bit. Page of Swords, just a little bit. What about the third month here? Death. There is something that they don't want to end, and I think this is with you because look at this, the Justice. So communication is going to come in the third month, guys. They don't want to lose you. They don't want to lose you, Cancer. So communication is definitely coming in for you within your second and third month. So that's August and September. All right? Let's see for Leos. Wait, Leos, wait. Oh, geez. Okay. Okay, dang, man. All right, Leos. We got the Chariot. We got the Chariot, Leos. So trust me, this person is not only going to communicate with you, but this person is coming to you. This person is coming forward. So some of you Leos out there expect some form of visit, expect communication from your person. This person is feeling harmony with it. No wonder they're moving forward and they know where they're going. They're in control right now. What about August for Leos? Will there be any communication in August, please? Another approach. I tell you, this person is definitely coming in towards you. 2-2-2. It's like they're done with the talking. Like, too much talking. Now it's time for action. There will be action for you. There will be communication coming in for you. Your person may be walking away from another situation and they're planning. They're planning to be with you. They're planning to come forward. That communication is definitely coming in. What about the third month here, please, for Leo? The Star. Your person is healing. Your person is like transforming, guys. Your person is learning to fill their own cups. 3-4-3. Emotions are gonna flow here. Because see this person, how they were feeling defeated. Feeling like they couldn't handle the situation. But you're getting over that because they're healing. So in your third month, your person will be doing more healing than communication. Communication will still be there, but they will be doing more healing. Very important, healing. Always important. More than communication, because if you don't heal, it doesn't make any sense this person is with you. Okay. Virgo, let's see. Will there be communication for Virgo in July, please? No. Ding, ding, ding. Straight communication. No ifs, no buts, no maybes. Straightforward communication in July. You've been waiting for this. Your person has been waiting for this moment to communicate with you. And it's going to happen for some of you Virgos out there. Second month. Yeah. This person wants to express their emotions, guys. This person wants to express their emotions. It is because you here, Virgo, is transforming. So there is definitely communication coming in. And guys, let me remind you, please keep in mind that this could either be the masculine energy or the feminine energy. Because you as a feminine could communicate with your person. And that could like spark the communication. Because sometimes they are there waiting for you to communicate. So So they get the go ahead. Oh my God, he or she is still interested. Okay, let me, you know? Oh, I explain how that works in regards to the feminine communicating with your masculine. Maybe I'll make a specific video so you guys understand more. All right. Let's see for September for Virgo. Let's see. Would there be communication for Virgo in September, please? The world. So something is gonna be off balance here. Something is, yeah, more healing. Something is gonna be off balance. So in your third month, there may not be any communication or just a little bit of communication. Again, it's because your person is slipping back into healing. You're slipping back into healing. But there will definitely be communication for you guys in your first month. No ifs, no buts, no maybes. All right, let's see, Libras. Will there be communication for you, Libras? Will there be communication for Libra? Oh, wow. You have the Three of Cups. Somebody here is working on their happiness. Somebody's working on communicating. Your person here has been missing you. There was little communication within your first month, within July. They're thinking about you, they're feeling you. They are totally missing you. They are looking forward to something here with you, the Hierophant, with a commitment. That's why they're gonna come in with that little bit of communication. What about the second month, please? Temperance. Yeah, they're holding back. They're gonna be holding back. Again, it's because they're filling their own cups here. Things are gonna grow between you and this person. In your second month, things are gonna grow. Listen, your communication here, Libra, may not be a lot, but whatever is coming in is gonna, how do I put it? It's gonna make you see that whatever plans they have for you is one of security, is one of prosperity, is one that's gonna happen. The Queen of Pentacles. This person has everything in order. 747. That's the second month. That's August. What about September for these Libras, please? Yes, guys, there's gonna be communication. Told you, your person is definitely working on ending something so they can come forward to you. There's gonna be a whole heap of communication within your third month. That's August, September. September. That's September. Scorpio, will there be any communication for Scorpio, please? Will there be any communication for Scorpio in July? You have the devil. There is something here that's happening that is not okay. Your person is still holding on to things that is of no use to them, no value, no real value, no true value. Your person is still holding on to things, insecurities. Your person is being held back by insecurities and things of vanity, things that are not positive. Low self-esteem issues. Whatever those addictions are. So there won't be any communication for you here, Scorpios, within July. Let's see what's going on for August, please. Will there be communication for? Yes. Yes. The walls are gonna come falling down. Those insecurities they were holding on to. Yeah, God is gonna intervene. You see that tower? I like the tower. I like the tower. And then boom, in comes communication. Clear communication. Clear communication. So they're gonna realize what they want, what they need out of life, and they're gonna be moving towards it. And that's happiness with you. Again, please keep in mind that this could be either the masculine or the feminine. Third month, the Hierophant. Yeah, that, like I said, they're going to be moving towards what they want with you. They were struggling, they were fighting, but guess what? They're going to get out of that energy. And that second month, that sudden change that God is going to do, like, what you doing? Get up, get away from there. Let go off of that thing. Let go of the insecurities. Oh my gosh. Sagittarius. Justice. First month, guys, Sagittarius. You will have communication. You will have that which you were seeking. Your person is thinking about you a lot. Your person is thinking about you a lot. They're feeling this love for you. There's going to be some action as well. So there will be communication in your first month and also action. So your person may come towards you. Second month, please. For Sagittarius. The Knight of Wands, like I said, they'll be doing more action than communication. So that's always good. We always like to see action, right? This person is gonna come into their spiritual gifts, overcoming the battles and struggles they were facing, which is exactly why communication is coming in. No communication until they're at that point where they can express themselves. Capricorn, let's see. Will there be communication for Capricorn within July, please? I would say yes. It may not be what you want. The communication that's going to come in may not be what you want, what you're expecting, but there is communication that is definitely going to come in. Somebody is thinking about somebody really hard. They're focused on this person, which is why they're going to be breaking the cycle of no communication. Second month, definite communication. Ace of Swords, 22-22, definite communication. Your connection is going to be growing and moving to the next level, the next phase, Capricorn. So what about September? They'll be making choices. This person is going to be like more within in your third month. And that's because they are going to be speaking their truth. When they finish, like clearing up everything here, making the right choices, the right decisions. And they already know what it is that they want. Aquarius, let's see. Will there be any communication for Aquarius in July? Damn! Yes! Yes, I would say so. Yes. Yes, Aquarius, there will definitely be communication for you in July. Somebody's going to be happy. Somebody's going to be so overjoyed in regards to this communication. August. Yes, I told you. Somebody's going to be happy. Somebody's going to get their wish. Somebody's going to get their wish. Whether you are your person here, Aquarius, you are feeling this energy. You are servicing yourself. Anyhow you want to look at it. But you're servicing yourself. You're doing what best for you. What you're loving yourself. You're taking care of yourself. So there's more in regards to stability here for you in your first and second month. There's more in regards to stability. Communication is still going to come, but it's going to be minimal a little bit. But the most important thing is that you or your person here is living your best life, is doing what's best for you. What about third month, please? Will there be communication for Aquarius within the third month, please? Oh, Jesus. Take this first tool. You have the Eight of Pentacles. So, like I said, this person here is dealing with loving themselves, taking care of themselves. This is them. they have to work on this situation. Like, there's still more work to do. And like I said before, there will still be communication coming in, minimal communication, but this person's definitely working on themselves here. Definitely, Aquarius. I love that. A lot of work being put into themselves. And there you have the Seven of Pentacles. It's almost time to reap your rewards. So there may not be a lot of communication for you, Aquarius, but trust me, there's work being done that's gonna, push this person forward when they're done. Whether you or your person, tell me about Pisces, please. Will there be communication for Pisces in July, please? Being grounded, more focused on self, more focused on self. There you go. Somebody is achieving their highest potential. Somebody's learning to love themselves. There are some Aquarians here who are lapping with Pisces because there's more about growth, more about stability, more about balance. So, see, someone is going to be going in here to find their true self, to find what it is that they are seeking. What about the third month? So, your person here, Pisces, whether you or your person will be doing more inwardly work, achieving balance in your life. So, there may not be any communication, but this person is definitely focused on balance and they're achieving it as well. What about the third month, please? All about, see, all about stability, all about self. All about stability, all about self. Self-love, self-appreciation. This person's taking themselves out of the cold. This person is not even thinking about separation or distance or whatever. But right now, they are focused on loving themselves. Somebody's thinking about communicating. Somebody's been waking up here, Pisces, and they'll be able to see the bigger picture. They'll be able to see the bigger picture. Let's get you some guidance message from Aries to Pisces. Let's see what you guys should be working on for yourself here. So you can bring more communication. What about Aries, please? What's your guidance message? You have community and health. Reconnect with an old friend. Friendships are like gardens. They need care and attention to really blossom. Resolve to call an old friend or meet them at least once a month for the year so that you can rebuild a sustainable connection. So, see, guys, you're being urged, whomever this is, masculine or feminine, to contact. You see, call, communicate, and move more. More exercise. Get a step tracker app and measure how many steps you walk in a regular week. Set yourself a goal to increase those steps by 20%. So, for Aries, some of you guys out there may have some health issues that you guys need to work on. It's nothing serious. You heard what the card said. Some of you may be thinking about changing the way you eat, the way you, just to add exercise and health to your life, your daily life. Taurus, what's Taurus's message, please? You have compassion, Taurus. Improve your listening. Everyone loves a good listener. Active listening is an important skill to resolve conflict and make people feel heard, understood, and valued. See? So, in order for your person to communicate with you here, you've got to practice your listening skills. So that if this person communicates with you, then you won't be blowing things out of proportion and starting a war, and then boom, back into separation. All right. Geminis, let's see. These are about time. Declutter your space. A cluttered home can make it hard to relax and can cause anxiety. A tidy home is easier to organize and clean, and you'll be able to find things easier. This is like the clear your space card, guys, so you can welcome what is supposed to be, instead of having that clutter blocking what's supposed to be there. Build your culinary repertoire. Discover and try out 6 new recipes. Try them at your own pace so it is fun and doesn't make your week too busy. What came to me, guys, was that some of you guys would like to start a restaurant, build something here. That's what I got for some of you guys, whomever that message is for. You want to create something. So like you have this idea. But that is a good idea. It's a good idea. Cancer. Community. Oh, encourage your loved ones. Throw a positive thinking party. It's a great way to build self-esteem and at the same time deepen the connection with your friends. You can sign the notes or keep them anonymous to help reduce the pressure. Yeah, so again, with the communication, guys, this will teach you how to communicate with others, doing something you never normally do. Some of you guys may meet up with your person at an event. Leo, let's see what your message is, Leo. You have make a new friend. That's community. So like I was just saying, somebody's going to be meeting somebody here. Learn to meditate. This is self-growth right here. Learn to meditate. It is one of the best ways to calm your mind and reduce stress. So some of you guys are stressing, but you gotta focus on your health as well. Complete a fitness challenge. So you have three things there that you need to work on, Leos. Okay, Virgo, what's Virgo's message? Ooh, that was fast. Growth as well. Practice daily reflection. Before bed, take 15 minutes to review your interactions for the day. Consider what worked well for you and what could have gone better, which is basically telling you to go within. It's telling you to go within and look at your life, see what's wrong, and fix it. Libras, what's Libra's message, please? You have community. Greet your friends with enthusiasm. Okay, this is taking me to let somebody feel wanted. Let somebody feel loved. Like whenever they come into your presence, express that emotion. Show them instead of hiding the feelings. Improve your posture. That's health. Good posture helps prevent back pain and makes you look and feel more confident. You'll need to change habits and strengthen muscles to make sustainable changes. And this is the first step on your journey. There you go. You gotta give yourself what yourself deserves. You gotta work on yourself here. Plan a family reunion. Yes, I told you these Libras. They are planning that reunion, guys. Invite family from afar and wide to celebrate just being a family. Community. Your divine masculines, divine feminines, whoever these Libras are, they're planning for that union. They're planning. Scorpio. What is Scorpio's message, please? Break a bad habit. Growth. Do you have a bad habit you've always known you should stop? Today's the day. Today's the day. So whatever bad habit you've been having there, Scorpio, it's time to stop the habit and you'll have to figure it out so you can draw closer to your divine person. Spend your money wisely. This is Sagittarius. Spend your money on what is truly important. Figure out your after-tax hourly pay rate by dividing your take-home paycheck by the hours you work. So, this is about building yourself wealth. It's about creating wealth. It's about creating stability. And some of you may have plans to do things, but you do not know how to get there. So all you have to do is plan for it. Just plan. Capricorn, let's see what your message is, Capricorn. You have wealth also. Ask for a raise. So it's like you guys here are connected because somebody here needs to ask for a raise. Somebody here needs to be thinking about their money. You don't get what you don't ask for. Figure out what the market salary rate is. Study strategies for asking for a raise online. Excuse me, and practice a salary review meeting in advance with a friend. So this is going to teach you approach, how to speak, how to deal, how to handle a situation, and it will prepare you for your abundance. You know what you deserve. You know what you deserve. Ask for it because you won't receive what you don't ask for. Aquarius. I'm also getting like for you Capricorns, it may also be like some of you, it's like again, you want to start a business or something, but you gotta take action. You gotta take action and also plan for it. Break your sugar addiction. Give up sugary drinks for 12 weeks. So again, this is about health. So Aquarius, you may be thinking about changing your life as well in regards to your health. But you just gotta keep working on yourself. Taking a trip, whatever, but work on yourself. Pisces, let's see what your message is. Protect your loved ones and assets. Create a will and sleep well, knowing that your loved ones and assets are protected. Having a will means that your wishes are carried out. If you pass away without a will, the courts will decide how to divide your estate, who looks after your children, and what happens to your pets. So basically, see, this is wealth. This is talking about you guys. And if you really see in your message, Pisces, it was all about the pentacles. All about the pentacles. So it's like you really need to focus on your abundance, on your prosperity, on your children's prosperity, on what's gonna come after. So instead of focusing on what is not there, please focus on what you want to be, what you want to happen, and most importantly, what you want for your children in the future. And somebody may need to be building trust as well. And that could be a trust fund that I'm getting. See? Just as I'm talking about the children. Indigo and Crystal Children, Archangel Metatron, you have a bond with children. In particular, you can help children who are sensitive. And Clairaudience, Archangel Zadkiel, notice the loving guidance you hear inside your mind or from other people. So pay attention to the guidance you're receiving, guys. It is very important for someone out there. See? Nurture. Maybe it's for you, Pisces. Archangel Gabriel. As you nurture a child, you nurture your own inner child. Both activities are important for you right now. And crystal clear intentions, everyone. Archangel Michael. Be clear about what you desire and focus upon it with unwavering faith. Raziel, clairvoyance. I am helping your spiritual sight to awaken fully. So you can clearly see heavenly love, a little guidance for everyone. This has been your message, everyone. Take care of yourself and do not forget that I will be posting the names of those who I chose for the self-care packages. Sugar Sweet, Suzuki, and Brenda Ayala. Okay? Thank you so much, guys, for your support last night at the prayer. You know that I love when you show up there, even if you don't even show up for the readings, because that's more important than anything else. Thank you, guys, again for your support. Love you all, and I'll see you in your next message. Let go and let God. Later.